coffee. It's so beautiful. The smell, the taste, the buzz. I totally get why people are so obsessed with coffee. But in this video, I'm going to share the 10 reasons I stopped drinking coffee and some interesting things about coffee that you may not know. So get comfortable, grab yourself a coffee, or maybe just some water, and let's get started. So one of the biggest reasons that I stopped drinking coffee was it was really messing with my sleep. And I learned and understood how this happens from a book called Why We Sleep by Matthew Walker. And if you're interested, I actually did a book review on this book that you can check out linked right up here. But right now, I will try my best to briefly explain how coffee negatively affects your sleep in a way that is easy to understand. So there's a chemical called adenosine that accumulates in your brain throughout the day. And as the adenosine builds up in concentration, it binds to receptor sites in your brain. And the more adenosine on these receptors, the more sleepy you are going to feel. Caffeine, however, latches on to these same receptor sites and essentially inactivates them, not allowing the adenosine to attach and preventing you from getting sleepy. And this is how caffeine tricks you into feeling alert and awake, because the adenosine that is still building up in your brain is unable to attach to these receptor sites and thus cannot signal to your brain that it is time to go to bed. That is until your body begins clearing the caffeine from these receptors and the built-up adenosine floods into the receptors and causes what is known as a caffeine crash, making you feel especially tired. So basically, the caffeine in coffee blocks your body's natural sleepiness signals. And since sleep is so important to me, this was one reason why I decided to stop drinking coffee. And the second reason is that coffee really messes with my energy levels. The caffeine in coffee is a super powerful drug, and I don't think we really realize it until you take an extended break from caffeine, and then you have that one cup of coffee, and it just hits you like a freight train. At least that's the case for me. And this makes it really difficult for me to know what my real energy levels are. So what energy am I getting from diet, sleep, and exercise, and what energy is coming from the coffee? Because no matter how bad my diet or sleep or exercise habits have been, if I have a coffee, I'm always going to have that peak in energy, and then I'm going to be followed by that caffeine crash. And that leads us right into the third reason why I stopped drinking coffee, which is that it's so addictive. Coffee is addictive because it keeps you stuck in this cycle of high energy periods followed by low energy periods, also known as the caffeine crash. And you can get out of the caffeine crash simply by having another coffee. And since most people prefer that high energy state, this is exactly what they do. That's why you see people drinking coffee constantly throughout the day or having one after another. They prefer to stay at that high energy level and would rather avoid the crash altogether. Me personally, I have a very addictive personality, so I find it's better for me to just avoid this cycle altogether. The fourth reason I stopped drinking coffee is because coffee and other caffeinated beverages are diuretics. This means they're gonna make you pee more often and could contribute to dehydration. Now, to my understanding, it's very unlikely that you're gonna get serious dehydration from drinking coffee unless you drink a lot of it or coffee that has really high concentrations of caffeine. But I do think it's important to note that most of us wake up in the morning slightly dehydrated. And this is because you haven't been consuming fluids while you're sleeping. And since we wake up slightly dehydrated, your body would much prefer a nice glass of water over that morning cup of Joe. Staying hydrated is super important to me and my health, so I prefer to just stick to water. And this brings us to the next reason. Coffee is an appetite suppressant. This means that coffee blocks our natural hunger signals and may make us eat less than we normally would, or even skip meals altogether. Now this is common in the morning when you have a coffee first thing and then you don't really feel like eating breakfast. And that's problematic because you want to be getting your energy from food and not from caffeine. Because food is what has the minerals and the nutrients and the vitamins that your body needs and craves. Now me personally, I'm a pretty big guy, I'm 6'4" and I exercise almost every day, so I have to eat a lot of food to meet my caloric needs. And having my appetite suppressed by drinking coffee could lead me to missing meals on a regular basis, which would be detrimental to both my health and my athletic performance. So you may be thinking, well, what about having coffee with my meals? And I am so glad that you asked, because that brings us right into the next reason. Coffee inhibits nutrient absorption. The caffeine found in coffee can partially inhibit the absorption of important nutrients and minerals, such as calcium, iron, and magnesium. So drinking coffee with or close to a meal can make it harder, and in some cases much harder, for our body to absorb important nutrients and minerals. And the amount that the absorption is affected varies for each nutrient and mineral, so feel free to do your own research. But this fact definitely contributed to my decision to give up coffee, because I want to be sure that my body is absorbing as much nutrients and minerals as possible from the food that I eat. And that brings us to the seventh reason I stopped drinking coffee. Coffee can cause the consumption of unhealthy foods. According to my super scientific research, only about 35% of coffee drinkers take their coffee black. The other 65% add some sort of combination of sugar or sweeteners and/or dairy products to their coffees. Or they're having drinks like the Tim Hortons iced cappuccino that I used to drink every single day. And the combination of coffee with sugar and/or dairy products is just not doing good for your overall health. Or your oral health, which brings us to reason number 8. Coffee can be detrimental to our oral health. Coffee itself is acidic, so it's already not the best for our tooth enamel. But when we add things like sugar or dairy products, which contain sugar in the form of lactose, coffee can become a serious threat to our oral health. Now we can help mitigate this by rinsing our mouths with water after we have the coffee, but if we're drinking coffee and sipping on it throughout the day, it's unlikely that we're going to be rinsing with water after each sip, and this is when we can start to run into some issues. Not to mention the unsightly staining that coffee does to our teeth. For me personally, I go through a lot of effort to maintain my oral health, and this is just one more reason for me to skip the coffee. Not to mention reason number 9, coffee breath. If you're a coffee drinker or you know a coffee drinker, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It's that terrible breath that you get after finishing a coffee that just seems to linger all day long. It's not great, I don't think anybody likes it, and it's just one more reason why I stopped drinking coffee. And that brings us to the 10th reason. I can't drink coffee any time of the day. And this is because of the reasons that I mentioned prior, such as it messing with my sleep schedule and not wanting to drink coffee with or close to meals because it will negatively affect my nutrient absorption. And this is a bit of a bummer because I really like having hot beverages in the evening, especially in the winter time. But thankfully, I discovered herbal teas. And herbal teas are great because they're caffeine-free, at least most of them are, and there's a huge variety of flavors to choose from. But best of all, you don't get coffee breath from herbal teas. Those are the 10 reasons I stopped drinking coffee. Now I must admit, I still do enjoy an occasional decaf coffee once in a while, but is definitely not part of my everyday routine. With my confession out of the way, I really hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. If you did, please give it a like and share it with a coffee drinker in your life. If you're new here, my name is Ryan, and on Entirely Honest, I hope to improve your life by sharing the ways that I improve mine. So check out some of the other videos on the channel and subscribe. I make new videos every single week about self-improvement. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week. Peace! Thank you.